Greg Lewis, along with former U.S. Olympic freestyle coach Park Smalley. Adding to the drama here today, Park, is the fact that there are several contenders for the top spot.
There sure is, Greg. Philippe LaRoche, the gold medal contender, is here, but he'll have to contend with his own teammate, Nicolas Fontaine, who won the preliminaries yesterday. The Frenchman, Didier Medard, Jean-Marc Bacan, known for their form and execution. But the Americans have their own Air Force now. Trace the Ace Worthington and Chris Fuzzy Feddersen. But the unique thing about this event is the higher and farther these guys go, the more excited the crowd gets. And the more noise the crowd makes, the better they perform. It's going to be a great show.
So here are the standings at this point in the women's finals. It's Elfie Simpson of Germany, number one. Jillie Curry of Great Britain, second. From the unified team in third, it's Charyotsova. The women taking advantage of the moved up start time and this little window of sunshine over team. Colette Brand of Switzerland set to make her final jump.
Allez full, single twisting, double somersault, big layout, full twist. Ho-ho, beautiful jump, beautiful jump.
Brand in fifth after the first jump has a chance to move up into medal contention with that one.
Not sure whether she'll go into the first place finish, Greg, but she'll definitely come into medal contention. Watch this extension on the takeoff. Very impressive. She waits till the last minute to get her arms out in front before she finally goes into her full twist. Look at the feet, pinned right together, all the way through to the finish. A little spread to land. Excellent jump.
Brand, the rising star of women's aerials, rises all the way to the top. 82.07, a two-jump total of 157.51. She's in the gold medal spot with just one jumper to go.
Not only one jumper, but a girl that can do it. Maria Lindgren finished first yesterday. She's a gymnastic background. She has a tremendous takeoff.
But she was the star in landings yesterday. Perfect on both landings. Her two-jump total yesterday was 155.74. That would be good enough today for a silver medal, but not good enough to take the gold away from Colette Brand, who has 157.51 on this jump.
Now, yesterday she didn't do her full because of the conditions. Today she's going for it, a double twisting double. It'll have to be good. Full, full, and oh, on the money with two-hand drag. That'll cost her 5 points per judges. May just be enough to knock her out of that gold medal spot.
Marie Lindgren needs 73.12 points to take the gold away from Colette Brand.
Had to be some pressure on this jump. As I mentioned, she didn't do her full yesterday, so this was a one-shot package for her. Comes off with a good takeoff, a little scissor in the leg right there. She's working the left arm, but she's forgetting that she's got to keep pulling with the right arm there, too. So as she comes over the top, she's a little bit inside there, and that causes a blocking, also pulls you to the backside of your skis. And which, as you can see, was what happened right there. She drug her hands down the landing hill. There's your first full twist, a little scissor in the skis. Once again, there's a good opportunity to see how strong her left arm is, but her right arm is not moving as hard as it should be in the same direction.
Marie Lindgren is 3 points shy of what she needed to take gold. Lindgren gets the silver. It's Colette Brand, who is the golden one today, second on the World Cup, but first in the Olympics. So the top three, Colette Brand, gold, Marie Lindgren of Sweden, silver, and Elfie Simpson of Germany is bronze.